Hi guys, so as I said, we will have a look today in the Sony Trinitron broadcast monitor. So it is pretty simple to open. You are just to remove 8 screws on 4 on each side, and the cover lift right up normally. There you can see steel cover. And here we are. So each side we have a PCB that we can flip. Here is the content. You can see some Kapton insulating sheet here, the picture tube, TFT. Power supply brick here. So I will flip open the PCBs to show you better what there is on them. Here is the vertical view for you of the insides. The power supply unit here, the back PCB with inputs. Then playback at the bottom here. So I have a problem with this display is that the plastic frames of the PCBs here are very, very brittle. In fact, the plastic did not edge well, it seems, and it needs a very little force to break it. So even with being delicate, I did make an airline crack here. So this side of PCB is power stuff for controlling the coils and such thing. I will try to show you the, and I cannot flip it open easily because of the wires, but I believe this side will be more easy to flip open. So I will try for you. Obviously I have a ground wire here to remove. And two screws. It is incredible how delicate is the plastic. The other parts have no issue at all, but this plastic is not good. So here we are, mostly. I can disconnect this and this. Yes. So here is the PCB, main IC here it seems, some delay line, the boards, lots of small surface mount parts. There is a lot of stuff written on the steel screen. You can see three similar transistor groups here, so maybe it is for the colors control of some kind. So in here, now as it is opened, you can see a little better. You have a power switch with a fuse, some filtering capacitor, loudspeaker all at the bottom, and one more PCB here. You have a good view on the picture tube now, and its deflection coils. Everything is made in Japan, of course. So it seems they are using a weird kind of look at these capacitors. They look like the surface mount capacitors, but they are not surface mount. They are through-hole capacitors in the same body than you should get with a surface mount. Quite interesting. And most of them are this kind, and I did never see it before. In fact, quite weird.
The power supply is just regular.
Sutling power supply. Nothing special there.
All at the bottom here we have the battery compartment. Very, very well hidden. And I can see the plastic frame continues at the bottom of the body here. Bottom of the case. Okay. So I will try to put it back together without breaking any more of the plastics, which are not good on this thing. It is a very regular issue, in fact. Plastics that become brittle. If you have all the Playmobil toys, you will know what it means. Very, very common thing. I do not have Playmobils anymore. Okay. So, this side is pretty simple to flip open, but the other one has a lot of wires to unroute and unharness, and it is a little pain. It is supposed to stay in place after with these plastic clips on the side, but it does not do it anymore. It is why you have the screws also. With the screws, no problem at all. There, and there. Seems that most of the screws are self-taping, even in the metal sheet, probably for saving some cost. So, little view on the PCBs. There are some bulge, as you can see. Some little resistors, it seems, there. Some little ceramic capacitors here, bulge with some silicon gunk to keep them in place. Nice silk screening all over the place. This side, no bulge this side. So here you have this thing. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.